After a busy morning of sheep shearing or mustering on the farm, there's nothing, I'm told, like a warm tray of sausage rolls or scones.
For Naomi Toilalo, it was this rural life in the South Island where her love of freshly baked goods began.
But now she's using her skill in the kitchen to create a more simple avenue for teaching Te Reo. Sasha McNeil reports.
Okay, so I'm going to make my takako tihi, which are my cheese scones. Every Sunday night in our whānau, my dad would make us cheese scones. Yeah, so I just developed this in honour of my beautiful dad.
There's a knack to the perfect scone, and Naomi Toilalo's dad obviously passed it on.
Does dad still make them?
Yeah, he's really good.
They're just simple, you know. He wouldn't add caramelised onion. That's a bit too fancy probably for my dad.
Growing up, life was far from fancy on a farm in Lawrence, almost at the bottom of the country.
I was often rousing and then my brothers were pressing or pulling out the lambs and shearing, and I just really hated that work, to be honest. But my mum was the master in the kitchen, and she'd bring up like sausage rolls for morning tea, and so you just counted down until morning tea and then you count down to lunch, and that was how you got through the day. Just good food, it was all about the food.
Dad always pre-cuts his.
We're going to do farm-sized scones.
And so her love of cooking came from, in her words, a very Pākehā farming world.
20 minutes, kapa.
But it's her Māori culture she's celebrating through her new cookbook, Whānau Kai, composed in both English and Te Reo.
The baking side of it, cooking side of it, and the reo woven in it is a great way to teach people because it's very common, commonplace. You want to coat all your puehu prawa, your flour, over your cheese. My mum and that had, they were part of that generation where they were disciplined if you spoke the reo at school, and so then obviously their grandparents and parents didn't teach them, and then they didn't teach us.
So Naomi sought her own path, completing a degree in Māori studies at university.
I know that there's this heaviness to learning the reo, and for a lot of people I feel like they're just like, oh, I need to be fluent and amazing, but I'm just offering a small way of learning the reo. And if all you learn from my cookbook is that tote means salt or huka means sugar, then you still learnt something. Hey,
a familiar face to the great Kiwi Bake Off fans.
I realised when you got there, this is new, the kitchen's new, I can't remember my recipe or how I make this.
She needn't have worried, finishing up as one of the top two finalists.
I can smell the scones, do we need to check them?
Oh gosh, they are looking quite, I think they're ready, eh? Good nose there, Sasha.
I think we probably should taste test them.
I think so.
Would you put butter on a scone like this, or has it got enough going on already?
Are you kidding? You must always have butter. Yeah.
Well, I thought you were going to tell me off for having wanting to have butter on them. They are amazing.
Mm.
Beautiful. Good old dad, eh? Yeah, what he's done.
It's a good man. I write in the book here, taonga I tuku iho. It's this treasure passed down. And so I felt like this was something to be treasured of what my mum taught me, and that I teach my tamariki as well.